Sorry about all the noise in the background, guys. It's Dragon Man shooting range after all, and so the shooting really never stopped here. Hey everyone, I'm Melissa. I'm the manager at Dragon Arms, and I'm also the owner of Honor Defense. Today we got in the Colt Python 2020. We've heard a lot of stuff about it. They were thinking about doing a recall, but they didn't, so we thought that we would get one in and actually see how well it performed and just give our overall opinion about it. So here I have the 2020 Colt Python. They originally started making these way back in the 90s. They stopped making them in 1999. They made them all the way up to 2005 for special orders. They started to really gain a lot of popularity during the show The Walking Dead, when Rick Grimes, the character on there, was carrying around his 6-inch Colt Python, and a lot of people were, you know, debating whether it would have been realistic in a zombie apocalypse, but they really enjoyed it, and it has really gained a lot of notoriety because of that show. Colt, since then, has completely redone the Colt Python. They sort of made a lot of improvements on it, and they finally reintroduced it at SHOT Show 2020. So here we have the 4-inch. So it actually comes in a 4-inch and a 4.25-inch and a 6-inch barrel. So I have not shot this gun yet. So first impressions, I have to say that as soon as I took it out of the box and I felt the trigger is really something that you have to feel for yourself. Immediately it gives you a really strong impression because the trigger is just so smooth. It's like nothing that you've ever felt on many other revolvers. So I was really impressed with that. I know they put a lot of thought into that trigger, so it definitely delivered. So a couple of features on it. It does have 30% more stainless steel sort of added to the framing of the gun, more so on the top of the cylinder and also towards the overall barrel. It has the really nice iconic ventilated rib upper barrel. It has the nice stainless steel underlug of a revolver. Right there, you kind of get the first impressions of a Colt Python, you know, immediately, especially because it has the nice walnut grips and the Colt medallion, that is really the iconic impression of the Colt Python. So you can actually change out these sights. This is something that was not on the original King Cobra. It has a really nice serrated sort of spur hammer. Again, the nice grip. The original Colt Python actually had 14 parts that they took away. It still has the really nice leaf spring inside that allows the gun to maneuver and shoot like a Colt Python, but with 14 missing parts. So they actually took out a lot of the parts that was in the original Colt Python to still actually, which is really impressive, that the trigger is now better without those parts. So that was really something that I thought was really cool. However, I do want to talk about the potential problems that this gun has. A lot of people have sort of shot this gun and ran into three different problems. So first of all, some sort of cosmetic aesthetic stuff with the crown. So it did have sort of some damage to the crown. Another problem was that they said that the cylinder was not rotating well. When you pull the trigger, the cylinder wasn't rotating, so right there, that's a really big problem. Another problem was that if they were shooting maybe imported ammunition, the bullets weren't going off. So again, you know, when you buy and you pay $1,400 to $1,500 for a gun, you kind of want it to work. So obviously, I understand the concern for a lot of people and some of the frustration that a lot of gun owners have sort of had with this gun. So let me talk about that for a second and sort of my own opinions about it. So first of all, they put in a recessed crown. So when they actually made the barrel, they put in a recessed crown specifically to ensure the longevity of the quality of the barrel. The recessed crown is really in order to aid in the accuracy of the shooting. So if they're gonna actually put an effort to make sure that there's a recessed crown and to not allow damage to it, if people are saying that there's damage to it, right there they kind of failed in that aspect because it just completely took away from their whole objective and their whole goal of making it a recessed crown. The thing about the cylinder is ultimately why it wasn't really rotating correctly is, you know, the problems with the cylinder was there was some sort of loose screws in the side plate that weren't really tight enough. The thing about the side plate is it really supports the hand and the cylinder. So if you don't have a functional side plate, it's not going to be able to really support the hand that turns the ratchet and therefore turns the cylinder. So if the ratchet and the hand aren't moving correctly, it's obviously going to miss that that pivotal point on the ratchet, and the cylinder is not going to move. So that was really important. So they said that, you know, they're taking back some of those to really tighten up those screws on the side plate. The other thing about the ammo not going off is, basically, if you don't have SAMI approved ammunition and you're not shooting brass casings and brass bullets, yeah, you could potentially have a malfunction. So they really said that you should be shooting this with SAMI approved ammunition. However, they are now saying that they'll make some improvements to ensure that it shoots all ammunition. So there you have it, the problems of the potential recall. They chose not to do a recall, I think mostly in part not to damage the kind of the reputation of the Colt Python right now. However, my opinion is that, you know, if there's so many guns out there in circulation that are having these problems, I would probably sort of agree that maybe they should kind of do a recall on this gun. However, we're going to take it to the range, we're going to test it out, and we're going to see if we have any problems with it. So there you have it, initial impressions. I definitely recommend, though, that you check it out. I am definitely kind of in favor of this gun. I do really like it. I have to say it's one of the first revolvers to actually make me interested in revolvers. I definitely am not a revolver type of person, so to actually get a revolver that I was interested in is pretty hard. So definitely check it out, Colt Python 2020. Thanks, guys. So today we're just using standard brass casings with brass bullets with the Arms Core 125 grain ammo. See how it shoots?
Don't judge me. Oh, third one didn't go off.
Yep. So try it again.
Nope.
Just keep shooting until it goes off. Isn't that weird?
Yeah.
So here, I'm gonna shoot it again. I'm gonna shoot like all six rounds, or you can, to see if it happens again. That's weird, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. And then it does get it. So it just means that like the hand is just not coming. It's not really working as effectively 100% of the time. Okay, so we put about 500 rounds through the Colt Python, and our ultimate takeaway was that we actually had a couple of poor strikes. It didn't strike the ammo all the way. Maybe it was a hard primer, but inevitably the bullet didn't go off. Maybe 5% of the time. So maybe after like 20 shots, there was possible one misfire. Also, the trigger kind of gets caught up, so when I'm going to press it back, it actually wouldn't kind of fully come back every single time. So I had to kind of regroup, reassess, and let go, and then press back again. So as much as I do love the Colt Python, and I would definitely buy this gun if they were to fix some of the problems that they're having, I personally think that they may want to do a recall. It would be probably in their best interest, just to kind of diffuse a lot of these problems that people are having. If you're going to be paying $1,500 for a gun, you kind of want it to work. So there was a couple of issues with the gun that we had that came out here to Dragon Man. So there you go, the Colt Python. Still really love this gun, still highly recommend it. Just a couple of things that need to be tweaked. So thanks for watching, and hope you enjoy the video. Again, I'm giving you so many chances to.
No, but you see my targets are not turning.
I'm literally giving you so many chances to redeem yourself. Don't challenge me in a gunfight if you're not ready to lose. Look, women my size have to be good at shooting.
Oh God.
Okay.
Oh,
I mean, even
though
I got some guns of my own.
Let's go.
All right. Loser buys lunch.
So try to load your ammo without a flula.
This is my winning thing. This is my good luck charm. How about you load 10, I'll load 5, and you'll still
what?
You ready?
Hold on. Whenever. Ready? Say, go. Go. You see?
Shut
mine is not
party. Oh, no! That's 3 times. 3. 3 times in a row that I've won.
Stop lying.
I win every time.